Mamba League. We got a lot to get to in this episode. We're going to break down some percentages of who could win the championship this year, break down some trades, and bring up some trades that should happen. But let's get to the big news. Touchdown syndrome Jesse Dunbar has left the league. I would like to wish him well. I'll miss those Wednesday night trade offers that I would give him, where I'd offer Lamar Jackson, Austin Eckler, Juju Smith-Schuster, Miles Sanders, just for Tyreek Hill, hoping to hear that sleeper sound that my trade has been accepted. Jesse, good luck in your endeavors, and you're out of the fantasy jail. But I get it. This league is a special league. I'm in 6 fantasy football leagues, 3 fantasy basketball leagues, and Mamba is different. Not everybody here is met in person, but everybody is engaged in the chat or in some form or another, which is pretty cool. You don't get that in most leagues. So I'm enjoying this league immensely, and hopefully we get Bull Pit this year so we can continue the jackpot raising higher money. But let's welcome in Matt. Matt, welcome to the Mamba Dynasty Football League. I know you know both of the commissioners, and you're living in the Dallas area, and you're a Chicago Bears fan from what I've heard in the chat room. So you must be stoked to have Chase Claypool on your team. And I look forward to competing against you, and go ahead and just reject all my trade offers. But I might be looking for Chase Claypool for an original second, my original second, which I probably do not have. But like the Pittsburgh Steelers wanted to say, the original second. Welcome, Matt. All right, let's look at it. Percentages to win the championship. Bullpit has 30% chance of blowing this league up and starting over. But Frierson, who's on fire, 7-1, probably going to be 10-4, going to hopefully not get any injuries. And then Think Fast, Run Fast has the third highest chance. And then Dicka versus God at 9%. And then the Fighting Heifers at 7%. I'm going all in on Dicka versus God. Going to bet some money in Sleeper if I can, which I think you can, for him to win it all. And then I will probably be the last seed, number 6, going into the playoffs. I have a 3% chance of winning it. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, you're looking at a 6-8 record, a 4-10 record. So they should be sellers, getting those picks for the coveted 2023 draft, get a quarterback, a running back, and boost the chances of the top 5 teams of competing well against Bullpit, because as it stands now, I would be facing, I think I would be facing him. I can't remember if we have a bye or not, but I don't have a chance. I have low scoring. That's why I went after picks, but let's see how it transpires, and make some trades, make some deals. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7 to the window, to the Waller. Threat level midnight. Let's get some deals going and play for next year. All right. I made a trade a couple weeks ago or a week ago with Alex. I traded Austin Eckler for a first, second, and third. I needed to get some picks. And Austin, I'm a Chargers fan, so I didn't want that double whammy of watching and having fantasy implications and also rooting for my cursed Chargers. That's why I got my Seahawks hat on. Go Hawks. Nothing wrong with those guys. Maybe there's something wrong with Russell Wilson. So it's a deal that took me a long time to come to grips with, but I did it. And I wish Austin the best. I think my thinking was the curse of the Chargers, and they get out of the playoff race and they rest him. That's a risk I wanted to take for a first-round pick in the 2023 draft, which I can hopefully find a running back or a quarterback, even if it's a low pick. And then on the other side, Alex, I'm sure, is assuming that now he's got three. He got someone in the flex spot. He's got Taylor, Eckler, and Chubb, so he's not missing out on anything. He's taking no risks, I don't think, by giving up that first round pick. All right, that's the show. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll do it again next week, and we can break down, see if those percentages go up, see if we can get some trades going. We need some movement. The top four teams need to get Bull Pit. Let's keep that jackpot climbing up. Money, 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 money. We'll talk to you again next week.